Yes, my name is Linda Moore, Garoute.
When did your family come to this area?
Oh, my family came to Prince George's County around, I think it was maybe 1850.
Did you go to school around here?
Oh, yes, I went to high school.
What was that like?
It was kind of mixed up because we were the first class that was integrated in high school. We left an all-black school in Douglas called, in Croom, Maryland, which is up the street, called Douglas, and we had to go to Gwynn Park, which was a white school. And so we weren't integrated properly.
Yeah. What was the popular thing? How were people dressing, you know?
Oh, we were sort of like
entertained by music wise. Yeah.
Oh yeah, it was always Wilmer's Park. We had Aquasco Speedway, so we had our own little culture and our own way of dressing. You know, you had to dress for fast cars, so you know. Yeah, my grandfather.
Your grandfather.
Oh yeah, he was the first Peter L. Moore. He was first black sheriff in Prince George's County. So, you know, everybody came to him, and he always helped everyone.
Like as far as Aquasco and Eagle Harbor in particular, is there anything you would like to see happen with this area?
Oh yes, I just don't want this particular area to go into the history book as a small African-American historical resort town, and that's it. Mm-hmm. No other history with it, where it is surrounded by history. And I want all of that just to, you know, be revealed.
We've been like doing a lot of research. Have you discovered anything you didn't know?
Oh, have not. Well, first of all, as a history major from Fisk University with a history degree, the War of 1812 was never spoken much about down here. And this is where it always happened. It happened right here in my backyard. And the Civil War, we always knew about the Civil War, but we never knew about Camp Stanton in Benedict. My mother used to talk about Benedict, the city of Benedict, many times. And we used to go down there in the summertime. But the history of Benedict, nothing. But they had the best crab cakes around. So we knew about the crab cakes, we knew about Benedict, but the other history, we didn't learn. And I think most of the people today in Aquasco still does not know about all of the wars that happened and all of the stories that goes, all the stories that go with the wars. They're not familiar with that.
Not even the slave, you think they know much about the slave,
mm-mm,
the slavery element?
Mm-mm. And plus, I didn't know Aquasco had the highest population of slaves for the whole state of Maryland. Didn't know that. I always thought it was Eastern Shore, mm-hmm, with Harry Tubman and Frederick Douglass. Mm-hmm. You know, we always heard about those people. And we didn't really put them together. We knew they were Marylanders, mm-hmm, but that was the extent of it, mm-hmm, you know.